Hey, this is JC and welcome to Small Brick City. You might notice the background is different, and that's because I'm not in my home studio. I'm traveling for work this week, and I'm actually in a different country in my work studio. This week, I'll be taping a television appearance where I'll be filming a TV show and presenting an original illusion. So I won't have time to produce a LEGO video, so this is probably my only video for this week. But I'll try to sneak in a camera to take some photographs or a short video to show you guys what I'm doing. I'll bring my stick figure along just to make it relevant to this channel. In this video, I'll be sharing with you how to create mocks. Specifically, I'll share with you one of the techniques I use to create my own mocks. And this is a very easy technique that anyone can use to build their own mocks. So if you're new to mocks, which is my own creations, or you're thinking about starting to build your own mock, you can use this technique and build with confidence. Most creators have different techniques and approaches to create content or their artistic creations. For example, if you ask different songwriters how they write their music, you'll get different responses. Some will say they write the lyrics first and then write the melody. Some will come up with the tune first and then write the lyrics later. So there's really no one real way, and most use a combination of methods. In my case, I'm a performing illusionist, but I'm also an illusion designer. So I create the illusions that I perform, and I've also published over a dozen books on the subject for the professional magic community. So I'm often asked how I come up with illusions as well. In illusions or magic, there are two main components of a magical effect you see. The first thing is the effect. The effect refers to what the audiences see. For example, cutting someone in half, making someone appear, or floating a girl in the air. That's the visual effect that an audience sees. Behind the effect is the method. The method is the secret techniques or the devices used to create the visual effect that you see. So there are two parts to any illusion. There's the effect and there's a method. Some illusionists or illusion designers or magic creators come up with the effect first. They think of an effect they want to create and they search for a method to achieve the effect. Some come up with the technical method first, and then find an effect that best employs the method. I'm the same, in the sense that I use both of these methods. Sometimes in magic, I come up with an effect, and then try to come up with a method. Sometimes I come up with the engineering method behind the effect first, and then I search for an adequate effect that best utilizes the method. So how does this relate to LEGO? Well, I've got many different methods and techniques I use to create mocks. Although, to be honest, I use the same three techniques most of the time. And in this video, I'll share with you a simple technique that you can use right away. And the technique is to expand on an existing set. In this technique, you're basically going to get an official LEGO set and expand on it. The great thing about this technique is you've already built it once, so you're familiar with the build. You're going to recreate or rebuild some aspects to make a larger build. You already have a template or guide to make this mock, so you really just have to concentrate on how to expand it, and you don't have to think about recreating designs, designing specific elements, or coming up with something brand new, which might be quite difficult, especially if you're new to mocks. So what's the best way to expand upon an official LEGO set? There are three ways to do it. The first is to make it higher. This is really simple, but it might be a bit expensive. But basically it means buying an extra or additional sets to make an existing build higher. This works really well for the expert modeler buildings. For example, let's just talk about the pet shop or maybe the assembly square. Now that's a big but expensive build. You can buy two sets and you basically add floors in between the ground floor and the roof. This will leave you a lot of extra parts which you can use for other mocks. But basically, there's nothing for you to really reimagine or recreate. You just need to build two sets, take the middle two floors of one extra set, and place it into one original set. In this way, you make a two-story building become a four-story building. This in itself is a mock, makes it look really impressive because now you've got a taller, larger building. But of course, you've got some extra parts left over, but you can use that for other builds. But that's a really simple way to make your first mock. Without, you know, being trying to be creative or trying to reinvent the wheel, all you have to do is buy an extra set or extra few sets and add extra floors. Now, if you don't have the cash to buy multiple sets of an expert modular building, I completely understand that. So here's another approach you can use, especially if you want to do something more challenging. And that's to take a smaller set, a smaller official set, and make it bigger. There are several small to medium 3-in-1 creator sets that have been released over the years. These aren't as expensive as the expert modular buildings, but of course they're smaller and less detailed. Many of them are also dollhouse designs, in the sense they're not modular, where the levels can be removed one by one, but they actually hinge open, and sometimes there are two facades of different buildings, just so that you can create a corner piece, but you can also close it up to create a small but thin building. But these are really great for you to expand upon. One of the 3-in-1 creator buildings that I did expand upon is the Corner Deli. This is a very popular set as it is well designed, there are nice colours, and there's also a very nice 3D sandwich sign. I personally do like this build, but I wanted it to fit into my LEGO City better, so I wanted to make it bigger and make it a modular building. I could have bought two sets and expanded upon it, and that's something that you can do to make it easier for yourself, but I did have some random parts from all over the place that I could put together to expand upon it. What I did was to change the style, so it's no longer a dollhouse style build, but a modular design. That means the levels can actually be removed, and they're held together by jumper plates. I made it bigger, changed the orientation a bit, and I also used the technique that I mentioned previously, and I added a floor, in this case, an attic. So it's not even a full floor, it's half a floor, but it does make the build higher and bigger overall. Making the changes I did is relatively easy. Even if you're new to mocks, you will be able to do this. You might take some time in figuring out how to expand the set and make sure it's stable. And that's where you have to learn how to interlock bricks and to make the overall structure stable. But you'll be able to do this and you'll have fun in the process. Another creator building that I expanded is the Beachside Vacation. In this case, I did buy two sets and I expanded on the building. I made it bigger and I also made the roof modular. This is a nice little build, but I do find the original set a little small, even by minifig standards. So by taking the parts from another set, I had the colours I needed and the bricks I needed in order to expand on the set, and it made it bigger. I think this technique of expanding on an existing set is really fun and a great creative process. And if you were to choose one technique you like to start off with, I would highly recommend this one. The third and final technique of expanding upon an official LEGO set is to double it up, and that involves buying two sets of the same build. I've seen many examples of this on social media, where people have taken two builds of the same set to create one large building. I've seen this for the Brick Bank, Downtown Diner, Palace Cinema, and basically they just make one giant build from the different buildings. This can look very impressive, and I think it's pretty easy to do. Well, relatively easy. One of the things that you generally would have to do is to do a mirror build. What's a mirror build? It means building one set first and then building the other set as though it's a mirror image of the other one. Now you can do this by simply reversing the instructions where you see them. So if you are looking at the instructions and they say to take a brick and put it on the right side of the plate, you just imagine there's a mirror in the middle of your plate and you put it on the left side, virtually a mirror image. With the mirror build, you have two sets of the same build, but a mirror image of each other. So what you can do now is to kind of fit them together to see how a single building will look like. And you literally can take out bricks from each half and fit them together so they form one build. So normally in a mirror build, the middle is, I guess, one main component or the primary highlight of the build. Sometimes it's a tower, a clock face, or the main doors. And the left and right will be mirror images of the sides of the buildings. I hope that's clear. This can be quite a fun process. If you're building with your partner or your kids, each of you can build one set as long as one is a mirror build. And then you can combine the two sets together to form one build. So you really get many different builds or different layers of builds within one set, so to speak. In some cases, you might get lucky and you don't really have to do much. You can build mirror builds of the same set and literally put them together and they will fit together to form a large building. And that's what I did with the 3-in-1 creator set, Sweet Surprises. Of course, you can do more modification to make it more organic as one building, such as removing one sign so there's only one sign for the same building. But as you can see for this build, what I did was I did change some bricks to make it hinge together, but essentially all I did was build a mirror build and fit them together, and I got what I consider a nice standalone building by itself. Another example I did for doubling up is with the Sanctum Sanctorum. This is a nice corner build, which is supposed to be displayed as a corner unit. One side is Dr. Strange's Sanctum Sanctorum, and the other side is Peter Parker's apartment. I wanted to use Pete's apartment because it looks like a real apartment and would fit my realistic small brick city, Lego City. So I doubled it up to make a full apartment and also made it modular size. I didn't buy two sets, although I could have, but I had enough parts to recreate the other side to create a back for the building. This is another example of taking one of those dollhouse style buildings which have half buildings and making a full building and also making it modular style. This fits well into my city and was also a very fun exercise because I also got to detail the interior. I hope you enjoyed this video on how to create mocks. Let me know if you have used any of these methods to create your own mocks, or let me know if you have another method to create mocks. I'll be really interested to hear from you. If you have got photographs or videos of mocks that you've created using these techniques, please let me know as well. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't, please subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Talk to you soon.